Good morning, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. Yesterday morning at 8:16 Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 4.1 earthquake west of Rio Dell that 244 people said they felt. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4. This was the first earthquake of 3 that occurred yesterday morning. Intensity level 4 means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few. At night, if they were sleeping or if they're still sleeping there in the morning, they would have been woken up. Their windows and doors were shaking, and automobiles that were parked in the parking lots would have been rocking, and people would have noticed it. On EMSC, one of the reports that was sent in to them from Rio Dell said they felt 2 little jolts. Another one said there was 2 rumbles. It moved the house a little more and lasted about 5 seconds. Another one said their Victorian home shook for about 3 to 4 seconds. Another one said, I don't think I've ever felt 2 distinct tremors so close to each other. Seemed like less than a minute between the both. Both duration less than 5 seconds. The first one was sharper, guessing 3 to maybe a magnitude 3.5, but closer to Eureka than most triple junction quakes. Another person said they were outside and they were getting dizzy. Then all of my hummingbird feeders started swaying a bit. They evidently didn't feel it as much as what their hummingbirds were swaying. What happened with this earthquake is they got spreading. The fault line opened up and moved north. And let me show you the location of that or the earthquakes. All right, going to Google Earth. Here's the location of these earthquakes. There was actually 2 in this location, a 3.8 and a 2.8. Here's the location of the 4.1. And I'll bring it out and you'll see there's a fault line here. This is the area that I talked about a couple days ago, where the zone is locked and they have lots of quiet earthquakes. Actually, they're tremors. Tremors and earthquakes are different. Earthquakes have a sharp jolt. Tremors are slow-moving vibrations. And these quiet earthquakes, they're at in Canada in the Cascadia watch area. They watch these earthquakes. Here is the Mendocino triple junction. Okay, up here's the earthquakes. I got a lot of notes. There was a swarm of earthquakes last year in December, and that's what all these red pins are. Let's see, what's this other 4.4? That was November 3rd of last year, 2021. Today is April 5th, 2022. Going to the stream view, here is those first 2 earthquakes that many people reported. There's another one down here. And let's go ahead another 4 hours. USGS does not report all these earthquakes. This is an actual earthquake. These are not tremors. And I'll go ahead another 4 hours. Looks kind of quiet. And we'll go ahead. There's another small one right there. This is all universal time. This would be 4, maybe 37 universal time. And we'll come ahead another 4 hours. We got another one there at just after 8:05 universal time. We'll go ahead another 4 hours. And this is what's currently showing. We got another one at 10:16, maybe 10:17 universal time. Here on PNSN, the day before this earthquake occurred, they have listed 245 earthquakes. On the day of the earthquake, which was the 4th yesterday, they have 403 earthquakes listed. That's all these little red dots. Now these are tremors. Slow slip, very slow slip events. Looks like a lot of them were happening there by Grant's Pass. Nothing showing up on the California side. Let's go back, because I believe there was some the day before. Nope. Okay. Oh, there was. I just didn't bring it out far enough. Okay, looks like the Sacramento Valley. You've been having tremors. Remember, there's a difference between tremors and earthquakes. Let's just click on, if I can, let's click on some of these. And there we go. Okay, a 1.1. A 1.2. These are all down by Red Bluff. And there was one earthquake in Red Bluff or near Red Bluff. The only one that USGS reported was a magnitude 1.8. And that was yesterday also. And this is the location of the early morning earthquakes right here. It's close to almost the same location last year where they had a 2.8 on December 20th, 2021. I believe it was the day before yesterday I did about these tremors and the uplift that's going on because of the movement of the Pacific plate riding or going underneath the North American plate. And this was an area right here that I showed you. Let me go there and we'll look at the uplift that's going on once again in case any of you missed that video. All right, let's pull this over. This is when they got all the data cleaned up and showing what's going on with that location. Let me pull it over. This is the highest uplift that they've had since 2014. Okay, we'll go over to 2014, and then let me pull this over. There you go. And I'll pull it back down for you and pull it over for you. Once again, all the red ones are from December of last year. And let me bring this out. I did in my report 2 days ago how this area has enough stress built up because it's been locked for a magnitude 8 or greater. These tremors come in spurts about every 14 months and they last for about 2 weeks, and you can see how we got a rotation of this area. The magnitude 3.8. Yep, the fault line moved going north and we got spreading. And then the 2.8, let's go down here. It also moved going northwest. It did not have spreading though. This is the 2.8. That's the 3.8. And then the 4.1. I have another GPS station a little bit farther south marked out. I'll click on that and we'll go to that chart and see what it was doing. Now here they're measuring east, the direction the ground is rising in the east. This one's north. And this is the one that's all cleaned up. Let me pull it over. And it's been steadily rising. I'll pull this over. We got 30 millimeters. Of uplift since they started recording back in 2008. And we'll pull it over. So did you feel this earthquake or any of those earthquakes? A lot of people did. If so, please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.